Hey, breaking news, breaking news. We interrupt this program for 85 South Show coronavirus special programming. How was that? You like that one?
Man, that's Fox 5 quality.
All right. Breaking news, breaking news. We interrupt this program for a special news bulletin. The coronavirus has made it to America. If this was green screen, yeah, we'd have a map.
I can see the map right there.
We'll fucking superimpose one. Yeah. It's fine. You know, that's what.
You see it travel at a gusting wind of 30 miles per hour.
You know, when I first heard of the coronavirus, it was in China. I never thought that it would buy a fucking flight to America and come over here. It's one thing that I've learned about this virus out scare or whatever it is. Is it a scare? Is it an out scare?
Depends on how you look at it.
We live with some nasty motherfuckers. That's the number one thing that I have taken from this. A lot of motherfuckers ain't been washing their hands this whole goddamn time. And they wondering why people out here sick. Because you got dick germs on your lip. Somebody else's dick germs. Non-consensual dick germs and pussy germs. People out here wiping their ass and shaking people's hands.
And these niggas wiping their mouth. And
come on, man. People going all in the store trying on shit. That's how germs get spread. When you know you ain't got no goddamn money, you going all in these people's stores, trying on their bathing suits and shit, and hanging them back up. Hanging them back up. Like nasty mother. And your neck dirty. Your neck, now the store got to discount this shit because of dirty neck. I'm so scared to buy hats these days because everybody just going in there, putting them bitches on, just sitting them back like, God damn, I can't buy that. Give me something out the back with a little dust on it. Can't even order food no more. You got to eat at home. Can't even get no Uber Eats.
Oh, hell no.
Motherfucker been eating hamburger helper all week since this. But black people ain't really tripping off this shit. Ain't nobody black got the coronavirus. I'm just waiting on the older black community to start dropping them home remedies and shit.
They already know how to heal that shit.
Come on. Come on. Put some of that Vicks on your chest. Drink some of that chicken broth.
And a little ginger ale.
What's that?
Oh, shit. This the book to solve all the problems.
African Holistic Health. I don't know who been reading this. Oh, but it's, look at this. Uh-oh. Mm-mm. Wow. It's too heavy. I can't even get to talking about this. Bro, I was on Instagram Live the other day. You know how people be like, add me, bro. Add me. Man, I'm adding motherfuckers. Then the motherfucking dude, I added this black dude. This nigga said he was the federal agent. I don't know if he was the one assigned to me, but he damn sure he had the mustache and everything. He was like, I'm the feds. I don't even know if he's supposed to be telling people that.
Yeah, you don't just come straight off and tell a nigga.
That was a very bold move, but now it's got me thinking twice about the way I'm moving out here, especially with this coronavirus shit. But ain't nobody looking at the bright side of this. Bro, gas is a dollar and something right now.
They done snuck that shit right
now. Boy,
down,
if that's man. All it took to get the gas prices down, 4 or 5 white people getting the flu, shit. I keep me a motherfucker sick.
That motherfucker was clicking. I said, I look back. I said, oh,
man,
shit.
That motherfucker full. Gas yeah. Spilling all out on the ground.
$10 will get you somewhere now.
We back riding man, for just to be what? Riding.
Yeah.
I call,
we ain't even mad about traffic no more.
Nigga, I called some of my partner. I ain't seen 3 years. And y'all still on the east side. I'm finna pull up.
Yeah.
It's going down just like that. It's going down just like that. Shit is scary out here, man. Hand sanitizer prices is through the fucking roof. Yeah. The stock market done crash.
What's the most outfitters, how to say this shit?
You had to?
No.
You be contact high.
I be contact high. With the nigga you done seen with the outfit, you know, to stop the coronavirus. What's the weirdest?
Oh, like the quarantine shit? What's the weirdest?
Yeah.
Shit, young M.A., she said she going to the airport with a motorcycle helmet on.
Yeah. That ain't going to stop shit.
Damn sure ain't. You probably going to transmit more germs than anything.
That shit didn't get serious till I seen somebody in Fulton County had the shit.
For real. They shut the school down. What? Yeah. They said somebody at the Waffle House got that shit.
Oh, that
That ain't crazy. Gonna stop nothing, man. Yeah. The coronavirus could be in the Waffle
Nigga
House.
Might order that
Nigga
shit.
Gonna be like, let me get mine to go.
Give me a patty melt and hold that coronavirus.
Nah, nah, y'all. We laughing, bro. Shit about to get real out here.
Niggas don't take it serious to somebody we know get the shit. Ooh. Ooh, shit, they done got James.
Somebody we like, too.
Yeah, it got to be somebody you like. Because if it's somebody you don't like, you blame them. All that hating ass shit he was doing, you know, you're going to catch up with
you
his
know,
ass.
You know why I'm... The only thing I'm mad about is Trump done dodged this shit about 3 times. He done been about around 3-4 motherfuckers with the shit, and he still ain't get it.
Man, they can say what they want to say about Trump Lous. When that nigga... denied his CDC visit, talking about he want to make sure them people in Nashville straight. I said, that nigga full of shit, man.
Hey.
Trump's like, ain't finna go catch that shit.
You ain't see a couple of days ago when them motherfuckers said, well, why don't they just get a flu shot? They was like, because I ain't going to do shit, you stupid motherfucker.
That nigga Trump don't need, like, it's to the point now, he don't need try.
He ain't trying.
Yeah, that nigga don't give a
that motherfucker going to fuck around and win again.
Oh, yeah, I can see it.
He going to fuck around
him,
and win
yeah,
it.
I don't want him to win
yeah, either, but, man. Shit. You want me to tell you what made me think this motherfucker going to win? I seen a picture of Joe Biden, and that nigga had a shag in the back like Ric Flair. I was like, nope. Ain't nobody finna take him goddamn serious. You can't have a goddamn white man, Jerry Curl, mullet, and think that you about to be the president. What happened to Bernie Sanders' old ass?
He out here.
Now, he's still in the running, ain't he?
Biden won a bunch of states tonight.
Man, fuck. I ain't think Bernie Sanders was gonna win, no way.
That nigga Bernie, he really don't care about the shit. They made him, they put him up to the shit. They were like, man, you could have won last time, do it again.
I just feel like if he was gonna win something, he would have won by now. This motherfucker been doing politics 52 years.
Yeah, ain't got shit to show for.
They ain't really, not really. Yeah. Cause he come from a state don't nobody give a fuck about. What is it, Vermont? Don't nobody give a fuck about Vermont.
They can't take you serious. You ain't seen shit.
You grown as a motherfucker. You ain't never even heard about nothing good from Vermont. You ain't heard, hey, man, this cheese came from Vermont. Right. We got to go fuck with Vermont. Vermont got bitches. Don't nobody never say
like,
shit
what? You know how every state known for something? What's Vermont? What's
white people.
Maple syrup.
Yeah.
White people shit.
And I bet it ain't Aunt Jemima. Mm.
That not even better than Waffle House syrup.
Yeah, so fuck them.
Probably one of them ones that come in them old whiskey bottle looking thing.
Law niggas be cabin. Having families in different states. You never heard nobody say, man, I got a cousin up there in Vermont.
Mm-mm. Ain't nobody got no cousin who teach school or nothing.
Nobody. Don't nobody move to Vermont.
I ain't never heard no blind people say they went up there to learn Braille or nothing. Vermont really is useless. Maine, too. Need no goddamn Maine. Joe, why you wearing this bitch looking like MC Gusto?
How I be looking, man.
That nigga Joe a hooper, man. Every time I can't.
Fuck Joe, man.
You don't take him serious.
I don't take him serious. What else going on in the world? Coronavirus. Hey, Italy say you don't got to pay your rent because of coronavirus.
Who?
Going to Italy.
Damn, I'm finna move over that motherfucker.
They suspending mortgage payments. Shit. People been posting pictures of at the airport, how empty the airport been with all the flights.
This the best time to book a flight.
Though. I ain't going. I'm really avoiding going to the airport altogether. I knew it was some shit at the airport.
Nigga, I'm talking about Delta prices looking like Spirit shit.
Shut the fuck up.
Nigga, for real. I just booked me a round trip to Las Vegas.
I'm about to book all my travel for the year then.
Yeah. Might as well.
Early.
Yeah.
Early.
Might fly me a little bitch out.
I don't know who been getting our news. This is the coronavirus update special for the black community. Please stay tuned. We will be giving away some tickets to see Lil Jon and the East Side Boys here real soon. Look, I'm just going through some hot topics right now. What a tour started back April 25th in Seattle. Yeah. Tour is going very well, very successful. Got to show much love to all the 85%ers that have been coming out and showing us love and they titties. Can't leave that out. Nigga. Without the big titty women, none of this shit is possible.
Nigga, Mobile?
It's titties all up. You know where else
they
it was a whole bunch of titties at?
What?
Titsburg, Titsylvania. Oh, yeah.
Impressed. She got the veil off a wedding dress. And she didn't put it on her jeans and wore it to the show.
You just came from a baby shower?
do you have on?
She done tucked the nets in her pants.
Hold on. Hold on. Ma'am, wait, wait.
It's too much snow outside for you to be dressed up in that bullshit.
Wait, ma'am, ma'am. Excuse me.
Hell is this?
What do you have on?
She talking shit too.
That's probably the craziest show we have ever had. 400 people walked up to the stage. Hey, man, some people love it. We got to go back to Pittsburgh. Shit, we got to finish the show. We never got to start the show.
Lose, that shit looked like the altar call. You know, when the pastor...
It did look real mega churches. Mega churches.
I thought you niggas were passing out blessings.
We ain't passing out shit.
Hey, man, you been doing the opening on the 85 South show. What you think about it so far?
Man. You been getting a lot of love, too.
Yeah, they fucking with me, man.
Man, we living in times where we got to respect each other. You know, people dying left and right. You never know when's your time to go. So just clap it up for us being out here and can enjoy the moment, man. Enjoy the moment. Because, you know, when people pass away, they put up their last memories of somebody. Might be their last picture, last text message. And I was looking at my text message, I'm like, man, I ain't ready to die yet. I'm texting female, please let me taste it. My homeboy texting me where the hoes, I'm like, nigga, you got him. He like, nah, nigga, you got him. I don't want that to be the last memory of me. So now I send positive messages to niggas. Anything you can believe, you can achieve. My homeboy like, bro, what the fuck you talking about? I was like, nigga, that's in case I die. Nigga, where the hoes at? Delete that message.
You know, hey, that's why I'm going to say this.
Say it.
God will have a plan for you.
He done broke God in it.
Yeah.
He done broke God in it.
Because God will have a plan for you, and then niggas will start hating on your plan. Mm. Nigga like, bro, how you do it? I can't explain it. It's just my lane.
They been asking you that.
Yeah, these niggas want to take my job. These niggas want to open up now.
My microphone can't believe it. My microphone can't. You done saw the microphone? The microphone said, man, shut your ass up.
They hating?
I ain't gonna say they hate me, but they want my path.
Oh my God. You know, speaking of your path, according to the 85 South Show News Brief, Lil Baby got the number one album in the country.
Man, that's a big accomplishment for Atlanta.
Hell yeah.
And then the nigga, he ain't wearing all the dresses and shit. The nigga, like, that's a big, he bringing that essence back. You know what I'm saying? That real Atlanta shit, you could ride around, play his whole album.
Right. You know why I fuck with it?
Why?
Because everybody like it. The old folks, the kids. And when you got some shit that the old folks listen to and the kid, and it's like, you can't really understand what he's saying. So even when he's saying some bad shit, you can still, the old people still like it. Hey, hey, turn on that little baby.
Yeah.
And the nigga got 600-700 songs. I ain't never heard a little baby song 2 times. Not the same one.
That nigga freestyle was a hit. You remember when he was in the
street? That shit got about 100 million, billion views, man. That nigga taking over the hood.
Man, he done took over. I like when a nigga do his interviews.
Yeah, because the nigga be like, he be going off a pill or something. Nigga, like, little baby, he be like,
He snapped like this. I thought I was like, the cameraman need to tighten up. I'm like, I'm thinking the cameraman was shaking.
Yeah, I fuck with Lil Baby, man. Meg Thee Stallion suing her record label. And I believe her. You know why? Because she fine. That motherfucker's so fine. Anything she said they did that shit. Free Meg Thee Stallion. Man. Get the motherfucking paperwork right.
I seen a clip. She, you know how she was letting them drive the boat? She pouring that shit in the cup now.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know if the money looking, you know what I'm saying? Hey, I don't know how the money looking.
That's what Brad would
But
mean,
I
Brad.
Buy a few bottles,
driving
though.
The boat. Like, get in the car.
Yeah.
They're getting in the car.
We got an Uber pool. We got an Uber pool this shit.
Hey, and Meg Thee Stallion is so fine. Hey, whatever she say they did that shit. And they need to fix it.
Her fine ass.
Yeah, every time I think I'm through fucking with her, I got to fuck with her some more. She just dropped her album. I don't know. I ain't listened to it. Real nigga shit. Not because I'm hating or nothing. I just don't feel like it's some shit. I feel like that's girl talk. Some shit I don't really need to hear.
Yeah.
Yeah. I heard she got a song about me on there. Captain Hook. Yeah. That's me. You know what?
I ain't check out the track list. I don't know.
That's the one she dropping the video for. The DC sniper got married while serving life in prison. What? Yeah.
Man, get that nigga a reality show. They getting everybody else one, man.
Let me hit the dope, man. I gotta hit the dope behind that.
Like, shit.
I gotta hit, man.
They got one show where these niggas don't even know each other and they become newlyweds.
Bruh, this nigga is serving life in prison. And he got married. That just goes to show you, it's niggas out here free that's not even trying. If it's a nigga who can't never come outside, got a wife. A wife now, not a girlfriend.
You know what kind of game this nigga got? Cause she gonna believe he coming home soon.
What are your vows like when you marry a murderer? You know, like, till death do you part or until he kill your ass. Which one is it? Damn, it's somebody for everybody.
Damn.
And I feel like that nigga just did, he just one-upped me. I ain't even gonna say her name. Because her fans are crazy as fuck.
Cool.
But somebody's boyfriend got arrested for not... Somebody's husband got arrested for not registering as a sex offender.
Oh, shit.
And that's all we're going to say about that.
I know.
Yeah.
They moved to L.A. They moved to L.A. one.
Look, that is...
That's getting too much detail.
Too much detail.
Yeah, let them figure that shit out. But if you know you're supposed to register, register.
Why the fuck would she marry this nigga? She is one of the most famous people in the world. Why the fuck would you marry a sex offender?
Look, the DC sniper. Like, this shit just getting better and better. Niggas can't lose. Nigga, it's 2020. We can't lose.
She took him to an elementary school.
Now, that's where they fucking up at now. Don't take the nigga around the kids.
Hey, man, happy birthday to my nigga Lil Bow Wow.
Oh, you can't call him it's not Lil Bow Wow no more.
Yes, it is.
I'm telling you what,
he's the same size.
But he asked for niggas just to call him Bow Wow or Bow Weezy.
Nah.
But I'm saying, if you want to disrespect them lows, you call him what you want to call.
That's not disrespectful, because if you go...
He don't want to be addressed as Lil Bow Wow.
You know how I look at it? What? I look at it like the niggas who be in the game. If your name is goddamn Lil Nav on the street, you ain't gonna never not be Lil Nav. You get what I'm saying? Nigga could be 6'3 and still be like, nigga, I'm Lil Pooh. You ain't gonna tell that nigga his name ain't Lil Pooh.
It's up to you. It's your discretion, but I'm telling you.
It's Lil Bow Wow.
Cause I hate for him to be watching this shit and get mad and slam the keyboard. Cause you said Lil.
You know what's crazy? Bow Wow and Omarion didn't link back up. They're going to finish that tour that they never
finished. They need to. Omarion is the prime example of a nigga where you got to keep moving when fuck shit get thrown your way.
Omarion the coldest nigga in music history. This nigga kicked the whole group out the group. Think about that shit. It's a group. He kicked the whole group out. And went on tour by his motherfucking self.
Man, them other two niggas were so mad.
It was three niggas. See, that's how far he kicked them niggas out the group. You don't even remember how many it was.
But I'm saying, Lil Fizz know he fucked up. But the other two niggas ain't have shit to do with it.
Hey, but see, we talking about all this shit, but check this out.
What?
All the niggas that fell out in the early 2000s is trying to get back together and finish the shit that they fell out about. Pretty Ricky is back together, nigga.
Oh, yeah.
And then they was on Love & Hip Hop and said they never got paid, ever. You saw that episode? Nah. They said, oh, dude, daddy stole all the money. Three niggas started crying, and one nigga was just like, man, here y'all go do crying shit. Man, it was a classic moment.
Yeah.
Bro, Love & Hip Hop be on... Bro, I don't give a fuck who you... Well, I be at the crib sitting around smoking weed. I run out of shit to watch. So I find myself watching Love & Hip Hop Atlanta because I know about six niggas on there for real. I get to watching this shit, I be laughing my ass off.
Lose, but how the cameraman know when and where to zoom at when a nigga about to cry?
Because the cameraman a real nigga.
He can sense
he
that
can
shit.
He can sense, like, uh-oh.
Oh, shit.
And then he got the white man in his ear. He be like, camera six, zoom in on Nav.
He about to cry.
Right. And, you know, plus it's reality TV. And that's why they try to keep, like, 3-4 motherfuckers on camera at one time so everybody can have
a camera.
So
you don't miss the cry.
Right. They're going to give you a camera anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, you know, that's TV shit. Don't want to ruin it for the people who don't work at TV because they really be believing that this shit is real. Yeah. Like, if you saw some niggas arguing and you just gonna sit there and drink your wine like they having a full blown argument
in a restaurant,
and niggas just back there like,
and you cooling it.
Come on, bro.
You ain't looked at no camera.
Come, you just, ain't got your phone. Your phone ain't out or nothing. You ain't get this on your Instagram story or nothing.
So Lous, this is my question to you. Like, you might have more expertise in it. So, like, if a nigga crying and they got a cut for some reason, do they come back and catch him on the cry with the cue?
You got to keep in mind, they not never stopping rolling. It's oh, okay. It's a white dude who the director.
Uh-huh. He ain't stopping for shit. So a nigga he really say that crying early,
you know, like when they be, when everybody be like, before you start shooting and everybody be at craft services and shit,
yeah,
they be like, look, under no circumstances do you ever stop shooting. Oh. That's, they teach this shit at cameraman school. They be like, the camera never goes off. Even when them, like when they be doing like exposés and shit, uh-huh, they don't never turn the camera off. They'll put the lens on and then get the audio from the camera.
So they might say cut, but them niggas still
ain't
rolling.
No such thing as cut, nigga. Do you know that it's an archive somewhere of some shit that you ain't never supposed to see? People saying the most fucked up shit, because you be forgetting you got this microphone on. And cut. Oh, I'm so sick of these niggas.
Right. And they use it against
Matt Damon.
You.
Right. Matt Damon. Make the wrong people mad. They got them audio coming out. Uh-huh. That audio is coming out. That's how they got Mel Gibson. Yeah, you better watch what you say. They gonna have the shit in a couple years where niggas gonna be scared to think of shit.
Cause a nigga could read.
It's gonna read your thoughts.
Damn.
That's some shit to think about. But don't think about it because they gonna know you did it. Welcome back to the coronavirus special. Yo. With your little sick ass.
Yo. A nigga probably watching this shit with a mask on. Nigga don't need niggas.
What if you just say mask off? Fuck it, mask off. Whatever. I got some more comments. This podcast is for niggas who thought the coronavirus was from a Corona beer.
That, I can see that. I can see that.
This podcast is for niggas who on their best behavior so they can get some of their girl income tax refund. This podcast is definitely for everybody who turn on their notifications so they can know as soon as we drop a new episode. Mm-hmm. This podcast is for everybody who look quick as fuck when somebody sneezes to see if they covered their mouth because they don't want to get that shit.
Lous, I think you should talk about how niggas need to cover their mouth. Like, what's a proper way? Like, if you give out these,
you know why
tips
why I would stay away from it? Because that's gonna lead to the reason why niggas need to shut the fuck up altogether.
Mm. Who, me or just in general?
Just niggas.
Oh.
Niggas do a lot of extra talking for no goddamn reason. Then they do a lot of excessive shit. And that's really what we learning from all of this. Now it's going to be a lot.
So quit touching shit.
First and foremost. First and foremost. We're going to start right there. Mm. But
this is the improper way, right?
They don't do that.
Yeah, I tell niggas like that.
Dab on the air.
Yeah, like that. Hey. So you keep that shit to you.
Exactly.
Right. Then you do this and go dap a nigga up.
Right. And when people ask you if you sick, stop saying you're not sick.
Cause you sick. You nigga, your eyes are yellow.
And puffy.
What the fuck?
You got the sniffle.
Either you that or you sick or you on heroin.
Hey, a grown motherfucker with the sniffles is sick.
Oh yeah.
You sick? I ain't sick. What? You sick, my nigga.
I don't know why niggas feel like it's so bad to eat soup when you get sick. Like, sit your ass down and rest.
You know who I can't stand to be around?
Who that?
Sick motherfucker who don't want to take no medicine.
Oh, yeah.
So you just going to get everybody sick. Fuck you. Selfish motherfucker. And that's why. Yeah, I saw this shit where they said they had to land a plane because this lady just started sneezing and coughing and shit and the bitch wouldn't stop. I used the word bitch right there. That was for that specific situation.
You
got to
apologize for that shit.
I'm not apologizing. I'm just clarifying. That in this situation,
if the bitch gonna sneeze like that,
she's a bitch.
Yeah, that's a fuck ass bitch.
That's a fuck ass hoe. A fucking bitch.
You took the words out of my mouth.
You nasty bitch.
Scandalous bitch.
And you selfish because you're gonna you gonna kill everybody because your feelings hurt. You funky dog head bitch. I can't believe they made Snoop apologize for that shit.
I wanted to make sure that what I said was said the right way, and I wanted to make sure that the message was across.
Bro, I was mad as fuck when he apologized. Then they went on the red table talk and they done guilt tripped them into feeling guilty. Man, I'm starting to notice a pattern. If your ass go on them red table talks, you in trouble. They ain't got nothing good to say about your bitch. Hey, why you gotta dress like you going to court? Snoop on that motherfucker with a blazer and a big ass turtleneck
coming up to his damn nose.
She gonna try to guilt trip him. Snoop, when you said that, I felt that. My mama felt that. Willow felt that. What?
Y'all all been smoking then. Oh, if y'all felt God. That shit.
He didn't say you doghead bitches. It was one.
And we knew who he was talking to. And then she done let Oprah interview her.
Boy, when they asked Oprah, how's Gayle doing? She's not doing okay. Give a fuck. Give a fuck about that
talking
shit.
Talking about she receiving death threats and all that shit.
What? Ain't nobody gonna do shit to you.
We don't even know where that bitch
Where the fuck Gayle be at?
Yeah, you don't see Gayle like that.
But then Gayle dropped that picture of Gayle getting out the car with all that ass. I did not know Gayle was thick.
Oh, I been knew that.
I forgave her right then. I'm like, she ain't mean that. We ain't perfect. We all make mistakes.
I could tell how she was sitting in her chair. I was like, God,
I did not know Gayle was built up like that.
I thought she was sitting on a pillow.
I can't stay mad at her, man. I can't stay
how
mad.
She about 60?
I don't give a fuck how old she is. She
still got that wagon. Man.
Gayle is thicker than the tension in the room.
That's why Oprah be hating.
Shit, that's why Oprah is so protective of her. You know how women have that friend with the fat ass and they be trying to, you know, come on, go out. No, I don't want to go. I got you. So we're like, leave my friend alone. It's just that.
Yeah, okay.
Like, stop, don't look at her like that. Put my sweater around your waist.
So they been trying to put Gayle in positions, but Oprah be protective of her.
I don't feel like Gayle really felt like that. I felt like Gayle was working. That's me, though. That's me.
I don't think Gayle knew she had a fat ass.
She did.
You think the whole time she knew?
This whole time.
Damn.
And you even know who I believe really knew? For some reason, I just don't know.
Me?
Nope. It's going to sound crazy when I say it, but I feel like Judge Mathis knew. It makes sense, don't it? Tell the truth. I might be reaching a little bit, but I felt like Judge Mathis would be like, boy, what you talking about?
So you think he just automatically knew?
I think he knew the whole time.
So do you think him, Judge Joe Brown, all them niggas sit around and just talk about?
Nope, because they black, they don't get along.
Oh, it's competition.
Judge Joe Brown get drunk and get to talking way too much shit. You got to put hands on. That nigga don't know nothing about no goddamn law. Yeah. I'm going to tell you one thing. I've been studying law 46 years, and I have never... come across such foolishness. Yeah. And you know what Judge Mathis is going to say? That's a crackhead statement. I know a crackhead talking when I hear a crackhead. I'm from the streets.
So the subject just done changed. Now it's back. Them niggas going back and forth.
They don't agree about nothing. Only thing they probably agree on is some bullshit like the Dallas Cowboys or something. Yeah. You know, two black professionals don't really get along.
Right. I can see what you're saying.
Yeah. Nigga, just think about it. Barbers. Go to a new barber. What's the first thing you gonna say?
Man, who cut you leg?
Exactly. Who been cutting your shit, nigga. Bro? Then he try to show you where the nigga fucked you up. See, like, you ain't had this haircut the whole time. You see where he been bringing your shit up?
Yeah. But don't worry, I'm gonna get you right.
I'm about to get you right.
Nigga, I knew my barber was full of shit. He was like, who cut your hair leg? I was like, nigga, you.
I'll just say that.
Oh, I'll make sure I've been getting you in the game. Nigga.
You see how I brought you back? Fuck out of here, nigga. I'm bald.
You don't give a fuck. Niggas don't even cut your hair for real no more, Lord. Now these niggas just spraying Beijing as soon as you sit down.
Man.
Like, dog, at least try.
Hey, man. On some real shit, they do need to start asking. Because a nigga would cut me up, and then this nigga started whipping up some shit like he making a birthday cake. I'm like, bro, hey, whoa. Natural on my shit.
Little
right, yeah. He even put gloves on. I'm like, bro, what are you doing? You got to give a nigga a perm?
Nigga had a little paintbrush.
Hey, yeah. Hey, man, let me just fill you in. No, my nigga, I'm cool. When I go, hey, I'm straight, my nigga.
Hey, when they get all close your eyes. No, nigga, I need to see what the fuck you doing.
This what made me really stop
nigga,
going.
We done put a perm
this
in my
nigga
shit.
Gonna lean my chair back into him and start rubbing my eyebrows with something. I was like, nigga, whoa, bro, let me up. What you doing? Nah, I love something to get. No, nigga.
There's a regular shape up.
Man, these niggas be going too goddamn far. I knew the nigga, man. Mm-mm. Hey, what's up, man? It's man Karlous Miller over here at the 85 South Show. Some nights I am trapped in the studio and I don't know how I'm gonna get something to eat. You know what I do? I pick up the phone and open the DoorDash app. Yeah, they bring you everything, man. DoorDash has something for every lifestyle. On the go with no time to waste, order pickup and pass the line. Delivery is more than just pizza in 2020. With a selection of your favorite flavors from across the globe, you can order world cuisine from the comfort of your living room with DoorDash. So make sure you download the app and use promo code 85South so you can get $5 off your first order of $15 or more. That's promo code 85South. You've got big plans for 2020, but when will you find time to do it all? Order delivery with DoorDash and take back time in your day. We use it. We want you to use it. That's why we're giving you the promo code. And for the people who don't know what a promo code is, it's kind of like a coupon before the internet. So if you go in there and they say enter the promo code, always enter 85 South so you can get the best deal possible. With door-to-door delivery in all 50 states, Puerto Rico, Canada, and Australia, you can order from your local go-tos or choose from your favorite national restaurants like Chipotle, Wendy's, Chick-fil-A, and the Cheesecake Factory. Get the app. Go to the app store and get the app. You don't have it yet? While we still talk, I got food on the way. What were you saying, bro? Go to commercial.
Bro, you remember it was time when we were coming up. You could go to the barber and be out of there in 20 minutes. That nigga done cut 30 niggas' heads in a day. These new barbers only could cut 4 niggas' head in one day.
Then they tired of shit.
These niggas want to stop, take a break.
Go to American Deli, eat wings.
Go buy more paint and cups and bowls and
I'ma
shit.
I'm going to tell you one nigga that can't never cut my hair. You ever go in the barber shop and a nigga be sitting in his own chair like this? That nigga can't cut my hair.
He could cut my hair before the nigga who lining his own shit up.
Don't never let that nigga cut your hair. Never.
That nigga don't even look like his chair been sat in.
Man, what?
You got somebody already? All right. Nigga just keep lining his shit up.
Boy, y'all stop doing that shit, Cat. Cat telling me to remind you about Oprah Fowler.
No.
You see that?
Yeah, I saw it.
I'm gonna tell you who petty is a motherfucker.
Who that?
The motherfucker who put Kobe Bryant crossing the rock. Now they petty.
Nigga, but they had the whole basketball sounds, like the court shit with it. Like, the sneakers were squeaking. It's some evil motherfuckers out here, man. You think she saw it?
She saw it.
She saw this shit.
Because they be on Instagram.
Gayle sent it to her.
Gayle fucked up 11. Yeah. Because that was the same day she was on TV defending Gayle.
Yeah. Ooh, bitch, they got you. Gayle, she sent it to her.
Gayle posted it in the group chat. Mm-hmm. You know that.
And guess who left a comment under there? Judge Matthew said, take this shit down. Judge Matthew said, this some fuck shit. Take that down.
Who else you think in the group chat with him? Judge Matthew definitely in there.
Yeah.
Stedman in there. He don't never respond, though.
Yeah, he just watch. Tyler Perry in there. Mm-hmm. I definitely could see Tyler Perry in the group chat.
He tried to post the GIF, but it'd be a screenshot.
Yeah. Tyler Perry only really posts when he got shit coming out. That when he posts, he do promo in the group chat.
He posts too many selfies.
Yeah. Who else? I can see, you think? Nah, T.D. Jakes ain't in there.
Hell
no. Nah, he ain't.
Kirk Franklin would be in there.
He cool? I saw y'all right. Did an episode with him.
Hey, Kirk Franklin cool, the motherfucker.
Yeah, that's why I asked you.
He a real nigga.
So you think he in the group chat then?
Because look, when I seen him, I swear to God, he ain't going to never admit this. When I seen Kirk Franklin, right, mm-hmm. I'm thinking I'm about to walk over and introduce myself to him. When he saw me, he walked up to me and said, he grabbed my hand and said, nigga.
You like that?
Nigga. I said, no, Kirk. He said, nigga, you funny. You funny, brother. You's a funny brother.
Yeah. Same nigga who made Snoop.
Man, I was.
Said, you the funny
brother. I was blown away. Because it wasn't over. That nigga said,
See, that's when you need the camera rolling right
no,
now.
No, you don't. That's one of them moments that will live with me forever.
But nah, Lo, just to see the glimpse of him, nigga. Because he said it two times. When you just explained the story to me, he ain't said it once.
Man,
he meant that shit. Like, he probably came there just to tell you that. After he told you that, he probably could have walked off.
What if he did? What if he was a fan of me, and then once he saw me, he'd be like, well, shit, I can. Yeah. Cool, now I see my nigga.
Yeah.
But that's exactly what Kirk Franklin told me. That is no bullshit. I don't even think I posted the picture yet.
When you do, you got to post that motherfucker on a Sunday.
Man, me and Kirk Franklin. That's crazy. That's crazy. I don't even really know what Kirk Franklin do. He not a pastor.
Not really a singer. Not really a rapper. But he talked that shit.
This nigga the whole choir director that got an album.
And the most famous nigga in my... You know that Melodies from Heaven? That nigga was singing the fuck out that song. Don't nobody give a fuck.
I just figured out what Kirk Franklin do.
What?
He the church version of DJ Khaled. All he do is talk over the gospel music.
Just hit it. Right on the head.
Come on, man.
What would you give him something like a Diddy, though?
He could be like a gospel Diddy.
Yeah. He a little smooth.
I don't know if he owned his masters though.
That's something to think about.
Do he got it? What record label he on?
I don't know, bro. His first album was a classic though.
What if they be like, "Hey, Kirk, why don't you go up there and speak a few words?" And he be like, "I don't really do all that. You know, I stick with the music."
Yeah.
I don't know. Kirk Franklin is a legend to me though.
Fold Your Soul Recordings.
Who? Fold Your Soul. Does he own it?
Yeah.
How it spelled?
Fo.
Okay. That nigga been in the game since 92.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I wonder what he was... you know he tried to rap at some point.
Oh, yeah. Big facts.
Yeah. Back on the... It's a cassette somewhere of Kirk Franklin going off, calling people bitches and everything.
Yeah, it's going to come out when they do his unsung.
Hey, man, a lot of people been breaking up lately, too.
Who broke up?
It's a lot of people. I don't nobody famous, just a bunch of local niggas. A lot of them, is it breakup season?
Shit, you know they done got their income check now, Lo, so you know how that shit is.
I can't believe motherfuckers been out here waiting on $3,500 for 11 months.
Nigga, I hope my baby mama watching this shit.
She be acting funny?
Man, nigga. I got to text her 3 and 4 times and shit.
For real?
Yeah, I was like, man, what going on? I'm just trying to see if I got to pick up or not.
Damn, my bad.
You need to get some money. Like, acting like I'm mad because.
Big flexing on.
Yeah, she flexing on me.
Wow.
But I'm proud of her, though.
Why?
Cause I just know that shit going to run out. I can tell how she's spending that shit.
Yeah.
She going to be back to square one.
I have been noticing, they bringing back them balling ass songs. Spin that check and get it right back. Like, yeah. like all on Facebook talking about we do this. Who is we?
I could just tell how she been eating lately.
What she been on?
Because I was like, cause her sister sell food stamps. I was like, if Kiki going to sell food stamps this month? I don't know about no food stamps. Like, yeah, they're talking like that. They got that kind of attitude on them. So I'm finna just grab a quick bite at Houston's.
Oh,
quick bite.
A quick little bite. Cheesecake Factory.
Yeah. I'm like, man, that used to be a significant dinner if a nigga go to Houston.
Where all these Ruth Chris boxes come from? Hey, man, income tax season. We'll make a motherfucker booty. They swear they don't like macaroni and cheese without no lobster in it now.
Oh, man. Bitch don't even know if they really had lobster for real.
Hey, you know what I'm loving about this technology shit, but I'm hating too? It's a whole bunch of people on Instagram selling food. They got restaurants that ain't no restaurant. You just got to meet them, and they going to drop your food off.
Oh, yeah. Nigga, they have pre-orders. Like, if you read their caption.
You're like, hey, look, they're going out Thursday.
Yeah.
Like, what type of motherfucker you got to be to know what you want to eat?
In the caption, they let you know, I'm only doing 20 pre-orders, so order now. Like, they talk sassy with you in the caption.
Damn.
Yeah.
Damn.
I support. If I know them and I feel like they trustworthy, I support them.
You know who else been showing their ass lately?
Who?
That I've been hearing. You know, I've been staying in tune with the community. I'm hearing that a lot of like hairstylists and shit are getting real bougie, telling women to come with their shit already washed and blow dried. And then it's like when you try to, I know it's true, because when you deal with all these beautician women, they be sending you the same shit. Tell me, you need to come over here with your dick already sucked. I ain't sucking no dick. You're like, what?
Now the beautician's talking.
Oh, yeah. Come over here. Your dick need to be sucked already. Need to already be hard. I don't want to do nothing but, sit on it. Like, what? Oh, wow.
Like, that when you feel like, I ain't no romantic nigga, but damn, nigga, make a bit, like, you know what I'm saying? Tighten up.
Man, these women really getting too aggressive with this shit. I'm on my way to drop some dick off. I stopped to get some gas. She gonna text me back. I'm like, where the fuck you at? I'm like, goddamn. What? You rushing me? You know what I did? Turned around and went the fuck home. You don't talk to me like that.
Oh. You gotta have stamina.
You know what? Never mind. Never mind.
Damn. See, that one I know. Soon, I'm gonna have that shift change, Lous. Because, like, right now, I'm like, damn, hold on. I was just making sure you was straight. Like, you know, I'm still begging for the pussy.
For real?
So, yeah. So I would have, how you just turned around, I'm making sure she don't need nothing from that gas station.
Hey, man, you got about one more month of begging for these pussy, because then these shows just going to be rolling. Yeah.
Wouldn't say begging. I asked two or three times, though. I don't really beg.
I don't never think you get out of that, because they're like, even when you get on the level, they still going to want to be the one to be like, he tried to talk to me. I ain't.
Yeah.
They want
to
be the
tried
one
to fuck.
They
ain't
told
to
you,
to you.
No. That's a prize. And then you can't just be fucking on them, because they'll have your business out there in the streets.
Oh, they going to do that anyway.
Yeah.
Folks.
Well, anyway. But, yeah. You got to let them know up front.
That's why I had to check one bitch. You know how you get the little memes and you put them on your... Bitch, tell me some, oh, you throwing shot. Bitch, you not my only bitch. The fuck are you talking about? Like, you ain't the only bitch I go through this same issue with. Like, all y'all bitches do the same shit.
Hey, man.
I didn't tell her that. I was like, man, that's just something funny I just put up. Because I can't
fuck
up the pussy.
Did you read my bio on Twitter?
These
tweets are not about you. Every time I tweet some shit, somebody in their goddamn feelings. That's why I have to be so specific.
Do they hit you up, Lous, and question you about tweets?
Oh, nigga, my inbox is so full of hate mail.
Hate mail.
People I never even heard of. Hey, Lous, you probably need to take that down. I be wanting to respond, but you know how one question lead to 100?
Yeah.
For what? It could be some general ass shit. You know how you just get on that bitch playing, like, hey, bitch with 1 foot, you know, 1 foot missing, be cute, then them up. Somebody hit you in by, hey, man, you take that down. My sister got 1 foot.
So, Lous, you don't even try to clear it up with them. Like, nah, that ain't even about your sister.
Because it's in my bio. None of these tweets are about you. Because if I get on there and be like, look, I'm so sick of these drunk ass alcoholic motherfuckers drinking and driving and swerving all over the road, they gonna hit my inbox and be like, damn, bro, that fucked up. You ain't had to say that. You know I'm on probation. Like, how? Bro, I never even knew you existed.
I still don't know you.
My inbox full of goofy shit. I could tweet some shit and be like, man, I'm looking for a bitch with one nipple pierce that like to write poetry. Somebody inbox me and be like, check this song out. That ain't got shit to do with nothing I just said.
Man, I died last the other day.
Nigga sent me some music from his homegirl who was stud. She clearly
he
was
the
stud.
Manager?
I don't know. He was like, check my homegirl out. And I'm like, why? She probably don't even want niggas out here listening to her music. What if I like it? And then she find out she got fans that's niggas. She gonna give up.
Yeah. Because that ain't her lane.
Right.
That ain't the fan base she want.
Right.
Yeah.
We become fans and she don't even show us no support, love, or nothing.
Man, all these real niggas bumping my music and shit.
That ain't what the fuck I want.
Yeah, I see what you're saying.
You get what I mean? Like, that's probably gonna discourage her. So I sent the reply back. I'm like, whose son she wrote this about? You be like, bro, no, she like girls. I'm like, nope, this about a boy. I ain't no way a woman got her feeling like that. How a woman gonna make another woman feel like that?
And your pussy probably better.
You the goddamn fine one.
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
Nigga, my cousin, he put up a post talking about he doing features. Get at him.
I saw rap. A nigga say he get in the studio right now. You need to hit his inbox. He doing $40 features. I was like, I know that shit garbage. I know that shit garbage as a motherfucker.
That nigga ain't even gonna take that shit.
That shit garbage as a
motherfucker. That nigga ain't gonna get the whole 16 for 40. Nigga don't even count the bars. Nigga like, man,
that
hey.
Nigga just gonna rap.
I ain't even gotta say shit on this motherfucker. My little partner done did it all. Simp. He sent it back. The nigga do the Kirk Franklin talking on nigga song and send the shit back.
$40 features. Nigga. I wouldn't buy that.
Do you have to put a deposit? So you pay 20 and if you don't like the shit, do you send the other 20?
Or hey, it's hey, like we should buy one. And then keep setting it. Hey, for real, we should put a track together and buy one and then just keep setting it back. You'd be like, nah, bro, you went too hard. Hold up. I'm about to change my verse. I'm hitting right back.
Yeah.
Hey, man, slow it down. You rapping too fast.
Yeah. Don't work the fuck out that nigga for the $40.
I'm sending that bitch back about 4 times.
Now we got a joint album. got about 9 verses from the
nigga. I love that verse, but can I get you to sing this hook for me?
Yeah. Bro, I'm telling you, you rolled that bitch, bro. But I think it sound better if you auto-tune it.
Don't tell him. Just be like, hey, wait till you hear what I do with this motherfucker.
and you just do it.
Right.
Do one and screw hey, and chop
buy,
it.
We gonna buy one of them bitches then put that bitch on a bullshit ass song. Be like, man, that motherfucker's going. And then we gonna get hype on hip hop. Be like, what would my boy do?
Just start fucking with nigga. Hey, bro.
Hey, what if you fucking
how much
around?
You think it'll cost you if I want to shoot the video to the song?
What I charge for the verb?
40.
Give me 60.
Got a nigga. So $100. You done bought this nigga.
Keep that nigga on set for 12 hours.
What if we change location?
Nigga. Hell yeah. You know we got at 2 in the morning. That's the location change. And yeah, hey, he's so sick of it. And we just, all we record is his verse.
Yeah.
Bro, we ain't gonna do your part. Man, we gotta get you first. Oh.
Do the cameraman be doing this on him though? Like getting all that shit?
He got his own camera. We're gonna bring the wheels out and everything so they can get the slash shot. Hey man, you need to bring 4 outfits.
Had a nigga do an outfit change?
Oh, 6 of them. Cut. Hey, bro, you got some more shoes you can put on? You got no more shoes?
Bruh, I told you no logos.
God damn.
Hey, man, ain't gonna show this shit on BET, man. You tripping, bro.
Somebody from the art department bring his other. You brought your, where your other stuff at? Is it in the car? You got a plain white shirt?
Oh, shit. So we gotta make the video shoot. Hey, they want me to do this little interview, but I gotta have you because you on the song and you in the video. Do we throw him something for coming to do an interview? Because we gotta do a little run.
Promo free.
No, promo free. So now this nigga book.
It ain't my song. It's our song.
Okay.
You ain't gonna work the motherfucker with me. Oh, man. Hey, bro, you got to do it. We need you for one more scene. When you leaving?
The footage lost. What if the nigga from a different city lost?
Yeah, what time y'all leaving? Oh, we leaving early. Well, we'll be over there at 4 in the morning. We really wanted to do a early morning shot anyway. Anyway, we can come by the hotel and get some shots of y'all at the hotel.
This nigga drove to the video shoot from Texas. From Philly to the Atlanta, and he was just gonna do a turnaround, but now he gotta stay cause we done lost the footage.
Cameraman ain't answering the phone. We gotta turn this in today. Wouldn't it be dope if that?
No,
bitch...
we didn't book no hotel for the nigga.
We spent all the money on the feature.
All
the
budget, yeah. Nigga. You ran my budget up.
Hey man, you think all these locations are free? It's more about your shots than mine. My shit done. I got to get you in sync because it just to match the verse. All the shit you said.
So what about craft services?
I mean, we gave most of that shit to you. We ain't eat.
So anything he rap about in the song, we trying to have.
He need to bring you with him. He need to bring you with him.
So now this nigga in the hole. What if he rap about being in the foreign?
That ain't got shit to do with me. We paid the deposit. In the contract. So
he ain't got the back in yet.
Because the contract says song and video.
So the nigga hit the road for the back end. But he gonna have to stay an extra day. And he still ain't got the back end yet. Because we lost the footage.
Hey. Then we gotta give him a check.
A check?
That's in the contract. The contract say we can pay in a check once the video is done.
Oh, so with post-production.
He sent the contract right back.
So we got this nigga a contract for $100.
Right. And the crazy part is right in the contract. We got 90 days to pay him after the video drop.
So we could.
After the video drop.
We could end up taking this nigga to Judge Mathis.
If he violates. He should have read that motherfucker.
But we suing him for way more for damages.
Right.
Detrimental to the video.
He ain't even read the contract.
Because this was the hit.
We paid him $100 for the song and the video, but the contract said he got to give us $3,000 before we drop the song.
Lois, do we get any residuals from?
Nigga, read the second part. We got all the publishing.
Oh, shit.
It was my beat and my song. I actually own the rights to his image.
So this started from this nigga saying he was in the studio. See him the feature. So he asked for some shit he didn't even know he was getting into.
He my artist. He can't drop no music. Let's not tell him to. All this shit he was doing for $40 ain't coming out.
Why he signed so quick?
He ain't read it.
So, do he go back to Philly pissed off?
Welcome to the music game.
That's a long-ass ride back. At least gas cheap now.
Where you going?
He got to go back to Philly.
Nigga, read that contract. That's my car. Oh. That motherfucker belongs to the record label. It says right here, artist is responsible for ground, hotel, and a ride to the fucking studio.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Should have read this shit.
Damn. I ain't even read that part, Lo.
Right. And guess what we charging them for studio time?
How much?
$120 an hour.
Los, I know damn well. You ain't charged that nigga for sending you an email.
Yeah, I did.
For him sending you the song back, you charged.
Oh, yeah. $50 because nigga smoking in the studio. They gonna get enough of not reading this goddamn contract.
Los, but I could just see this shit could get ugly because he might go to shade room and try to, you know, bad mouth you.
You better read this part of the contract because it said non-disclosure. If he get on social media,
so he can't even talk about that shit.
Read this. We own a social media page. That shit belong to the company. We own his image. That nigga posted a picture. We got a proof. We got last say so over all that. Nigga can't go live or none of that.
So, Lous, can he get footage of the video shoot?
My footage?
I'm saying with his phone.
Oh, that's my footage, though, because that's my image.
Damn.
Yeah, we own the like. He can't use the likeliness or nothing.
Damn.
Yeah.
All from a $40 feature. You think he spent the money as soon as he got it?
I know he did. This nigga bought a 7. Then had the nigga bring it to him.
Oh, he think he a baller.
What? Bullshit. What's wrong? Better not violate this contract, I tell you that.
Done fucked up his transmission coming to Atlanta.
In my car.
Ain't in your car. That nigga probably. I don't know. So did he scan it back or did he faxed it back.
He sent that bitch right. He emailed it and he faxed it.
Oh, he was happy.
I got two copies of it on file. He became violating neither one of them.
Damn, Lous.
Welcome to the music industry.
Shit, he asked for it.
Hey, man. We're gonna get that nigga on that feature, though.
Yeah.
We got to. You know, we got an album coming out. I ain't been saying nothing about it because, you know, I don't want people to take it the wrong way. But we do have some new shit coming from 85 South Shore Records. Some shit you can make love to your lady to.
Could he see himself making the album?
Who?
I'm going to call him 40.
With my approval.
Oh, okay.
You got to find a say-so.
He got to come hard, though.
Get full creative control of whatever comes out.
So he could blow up after it, possibly?
If I let him.
Damn.
Better not violate this goddamn contract.
So how? That's about 2 or 3 pages.
He sent it right back.
But Lous, you know, if you don't initial each part, he could like get out of certain shit with that.
He wrote his full name even on the initial part. He just wrote it small.
I tried to help him. Fuck it. He
fuck
did.
It, man. You did the best you could.
Yeah. Tried to get.
Hey, man. Any advice you want to give these niggas out here on the street? I mean, I keep saying niggas, but I don't want the white people to feel alienated. You know, 85% is coming all shapes, sizes, and colors. Yeah. Have you seen them? Sometimes I've been thinking.
It's a multicultural fan base, man.
Right, right.
I noticed it's more whites who leave the comments than blacks.
Because they've been logged into YouTube watching cat videos and shit. We appreciate it. You know, that's why our views is going up. Because we're spilling over into other communities. Like these minorities, they starting to take this shit back to the community. I seen some old-ass white people at some 85 South Shore. I'm like, where are they watching this shit at? I watch you on Wellin' Out. Yeah, some people they still ain't hip yet. Yeah. Hit my website and get you one of these dope ass hoodies. Quit touching shit. I was at the bank and that little lady was like, I tell my little nephew that all the time.
Quit touching shit.
I think she gonna buy one.
She should have bought one right then. Yeah. But did you let her know you got them?
I did.
Okay.
I did. A lot of epidemics are going around. Please stay safe and wash your hands and your ass. Coronavirus has entered America straight from North Korea. Manufactured drugs. But we're not even going to get into conspiracy theories tonight, or are you? You want to? Because there's a lot of conspiracy theories out there, too.
I like a good subject that you said, like, wash your hands and your ass. Because Jessica, you can have the cleanest hands. But if you ain't washing your ass, you still touching a dirty body.
Yep. Because one thing about an ass, it'll only stink for a couple of hours. It don't take long for your ass to get funky. No, always keep that in mind. Always keep that in mind. That's why old niggas, that's their first go-to insult. Oh, funky ass. Tell me.
Because they just know. You've been around here for 3 hours.
Mm-hmm. That's what started most arguments with young people and old people. You done laid around here all day, ain't even wash your ass. Exactly. I know a lot of women that lay around all day with their hair not done, and you know they ain't washed their ass all day long. I was going live. Well, man, this live shit was crazy. I don't know where you were the other day when I was going live on Instagram. I hit this one girl. She laying around the house, laying in the bed at 3-4 o'clock in the afternoon. Get your nasty ass up. Why are you
just
still
chilling?
Just laying around.
You ain't answer what she.
I don't usually look like this. Yes, the fuck
yes,
you do.
You do.
If I would have called you any day of the week at 3-4 o'clock,
you because you
wouldn't
have gave me that disclaimer.
Yeah, then be talking shit like she's so fine. Girl, get your stinking ass up out that bed and wash that pussy. Hello, my bad. I ain't have to take it that far because you knew what I meant while I was going with that. All right, let me see. This is a good comment to slide to.
What that?
Somebody said they still singing. Got my chopper on the dresser, baby. Ready to shoot.
That's a hit.
It's been a hit. That's why we did it.
That's a hit.
We drop great music over here. We got people singing shit that they ain't supposed to be singing.
They don't even know the whole.
You know, teachers are starting to incorporate 85 South Shore into the curriculum.
For real?
Yes.
What subject?
All of them. The things that we are speaking about are things that they can't even say. but they have connected with the students in another level.
So they're taking the clips and
they're clipping them out.
Yeah, okay.
We don't always say the right things. We don't always say it, but we're not always pitching.
Yeah, but sometimes you got to hear it like that because that's how the kids could comprehend.
Mm-hmm.
If you ain't talking about ass and titties, they ain't paying attention.
No, it's not even about the ass and titties, but like sometimes when we speak on those things, we giving them information that they didn't know about. You know, it's like sometimes when you speak the language, they get it. Who else they gonna hear say this type of shit?
Do tell.
And they always be like, hey man, watch your language, the kids are in here. Who the fuck you think doing all the cussing?
Yeah.
Why you think they fuck with us so hard?
Kids cuss more than the adults.
You motherfucking right. All of them. Six, seven, eight, 9 years old. How you think they became friends?
Yeah, cause I slowed down when I became an adult. I said, man, I done cussed way too much as a kid. I took a break from
that. I don't like adults that don't cuss, honestly. Yeah. Can you imagine fucking somebody and then they don't curse, but they still want to try to use like substitute curse?
Dang.
Oh, shoot. Oh, shoot. Yeah. Gosh darn it.
Daggone it. Oh, man, shut the fuck up. Man.
Please, just be quiet.
Yeah, don't even worry about it. If my dick ain't worth you cussing, then you don't need this.
You don't.
Yeah. Hit me with a fuck.
Act a fool about my shit.
Fuck. Yeah, told y'all we're gonna do.
This episode is sponsored by Blue Chew. My name is Karlous Miller. BlueChew.com. Trust me. At this point, you already know. It's people asking me, man, what that Blue Chew do? Blue Chew brings you the first chewable with the same FDA-approved active ingredients as Viagra and Cialis. And it's a sexual stimulant. Now, it's not going to cure any ailments or anything like that. But it will have you making sweet, sweet love to your lady.
BlueChew.com.
If you can benefit from more confidence where it counts, Blue Chew is the fastest and easiest way to enhance your performance. These pills are amazing. Go check them out at BlueChew.com. If you could use a confidence boost or you just want to feel like your old self again, trust your mans. Use the promo code. It's only $5, man. You can try it for $5. Go online, bluechew.com. You can go right on your phone. That's Blue, B-L-U-E, Chew, C-H-E-W.com. Hey, man, make sure you hit that website and use their promo code. I just want you to see what all the hype is about. You get what I'm saying? Trust me on this. Use the promo code. Get your first shipment for free. 85 South. I put that on everything. Times is hard out here. You feel me?
There's a lot of bad pussy going around.
Yeah. And then they be bragging.
I don't know if it's going around or it's been around.
It's been around.
Yeah. Like, you ever be on like social media and then you see like somebody, like a chick you fucked one time, talking shit about niggas and be like, you can't act like that.
Yeah.
You don't even have the right equipment.
You ain't got that type of pussy.
Yeah.
Some bitch be wanting to do what they friends do. Like,
you don't know. She swallowed the whole dick.
She
eat the whole dick off the body. Y'all are in two different lanes.
Nigga put up with her attitude.
Right.
I had to tell my homeboy that.
Sometimes you can't be that raw with him. Like, look, ma'am, she has three holes. You have two. Okay? The difference between a two-holer and a three-holer, that's like driving a stick in an automatic.
Big difference.
Big difference.
Yeah.
Power stroke diesel. Look, I told you I don't always say the right things, but the things I say are always correct. And we are broadcasting live from the safety of our coronavirus fallout shelter.
Yeah, everybody, this shit coronavirus proof.
Everybody in here
this shit
is immune to that shit.
Yeah.
It'd be fucked up if niggas start getting that shit, though, man.
Man, I hope not.
Mm-hmm. We got it hard enough. That shit would
come on.
Decimate the rest of our community. We still ain't recovered from the crack years.
Yeah. Like, man, them niggas done had it hard enough. Like, don't get them niggas the coronavirus.
Don't give them that. Yeah, leave us out of this one. Let us have this one. Like, make us feel special one goddamn time.
Right.
Oh, black people, y'all ain't got to worry about this one. Woo! Shit,
that should do
tax time too.
They should do a broadcast about that shit.
Let me hit these folks back. They think I'm
I want to do my white teacher when I was in third grade. Got that shit.
She probably don't. She probably ain't even alive no more.
Nah, she still alive. She was young when I was. She was fresh out of college.
Yeah, she ain't got that shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. You be worried about people like that?
Yeah, man. I sometimes sit and think about it, like what.
You had some white people that had an impact on your life.
I had one teacher. She believed in me, man.
Like believed in what?
Like she just saw some shit in me that I was in second grade. She was like, I don't know what you planning to be in the future, but you gonna make it.
What are you planning to be in the future? This was part of the plan.
God, we talked about it in the early segment. My plan is just coming.
It's coming together.
It's coming together. I ain't even see this shit, man.
I am not the man to question you and God's plan.
Yeah, but I ain't even see
this. I just wish you the best on whatever it is that you're becoming.
Hey, but you helping the plan fold out, though.
I am.
Yeah.
No, that's why I invited you to the safety of this Corona fallout shit. I don't want you out there living like the Walking Dead. Oh, not my nigga.
I appreciate that, man.
Not my nigga. Hell no, bro. That's what I've been working on, too. You know, I've been, like, in the studio just doing a lot of rewrites for shit. I'm working on the black version of The Walking Dead with all black zombies, all black cast members.
See, Lous, like, you kind of pissed me off because you had me so excited about the show.
Which one?
About, you know, when you go be with the white family.
Oh, the Bradley.
Yeah, see.
Oh, you thought I forgot about that?
Yeah, man, because I've been looking for the audition to pop up.
How long you think it take to develop a TV show, bro? You got a lot to learn about this industry.
But I'm saying, Lous, like, when damn, I said the streets ready and you bullshit.
Man, you don't move when the streets is ready. You move when the timing is right. That's what I want, Nav. I wanted enough time to pass where people forget about it. Then when I bust their ass in the head with it, they be like, oh, this is my new shit. And I'm glad you did it right, Lous, because you got with such and such network and the shit look good.
But Lous, man, you ain't even started pre-production. You ain't even casting.
You don't know what the fuck I've been doing.
Well, you ain't let me know I could audition for some
shit.
See,
you really just anxious because you want your part. You really just anxious because you want your part.
Man, so you done picked another nigga to play the janitor?
No.
All right. Shit, I'll make sure.
Who the fuck gonna be the shift leader? All
right. I'll make sure I'm in
there. Man, I don't know. Hey, I saw McDonald's got a new Big Mac coming out with four patties on that bitch. Right, man. Now they just flexing, ain't
they? Yeah, they just flexing.
Income tax burger.
Yeah, that's just some shit, like, with so much shit going on. Just a social media hoax.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just something to keep the spirits
just
up.
Just to get niggas talking.
Right.
Yeah, you know how the game go, man.
I know how it is, man. I ain't mad at that shit at all. I'm fucking with it, actually. You know, McDonald's always recreating themselves. They just like a bad bitch. They keep their hair done and keep.
Oh yeah, they gonna keep it fresh.
Right, they definitely.
And funky.
Gonna, right, cause these motherfuckers getting good at shit that they ain't even supposed to be good at. The Mac Cafe. These motherfuckers got a whole little coffee shop, ice cream machine, still broke.
And now Starbucks want to beef with niggas.
That's what it is.
See, I ain't even supposed to be telling niggas that, but I fuck with you so hard, I already know you gonna take that and
hey, Starbucks, chop it up. Starbucks been on some whole shit, bro.
Ever since they locked them folks up.
But they said all you could get a small Starbucks drink and it's the same size as the goddamn large.
Oh yeah.
It's the same amount of shit in all three cups. Now I never passed that part of, you know, math when they was showing you like pints and quarts and shit. Mm-hmm. But I know for a fact that the goddamn is supposed to be at least a small difference between the small, medium, and the large.
I
knew there was some bullshit when they changed the name from small, medium, to large.
To what?
To Monde, Grande,
Grande,
Venti, and whatever.
Some with a V.
Come on, Venti.
Yeah.
Right, that's some bullshit.
I knew they were full of shit, Lous. Them motherfuckers talking about how strong you want it. Bitch. Come is on, it liquor man. Or coffee?
How the fuck Starbucks gonna sell you all them snacks and they old? Them all them goddamn danishes and shit. They
man,
never
them
fresh.
Hard ass biscuits.
Then they got the nerve to be goddamn charging $6-$7 for this old ass blueberry muffin. Starbucks really on some bullshit.
Man. Lous, let me tell you this, man.
Talk your shit, bro.
Motherfucker.
See, they don't have a platform where black men can speak on the economy.
And vent. And basically vent.
Right. Talk your shit, bro.
A motherfucker for Secret Santa gave me a Starbucks gift card. Now the motherfucker just sitting in my car. What the fuck I'm gonna do with it?
Go use that bitch and act like you've been doing. Practice the shit.
Pull but Lous, you ain't let me get to the point. How I much try on? To go you $10.
That's enough for
$10. Nah, I gotta put money with the shit. I ain't just gonna get one coffee. I gotta get a sandwich with it. The sandwich $7.
Yeah.
The coffee $5.
Right.
Bitch, that's $12.
Right. But they're going in there and spend that shit.
No, I'm gonna re-rock and give it to somebody else. Right. I'm gonna get that card to somebody else.
I take that motherfucker. I damn sure take it. Sell it to me for the folk.
What? The $10 card?
You don't want
it was a gift, man.
So what?
I don't give away gifts like that, no.
Sell it to me. You said you gonna get re-gifted.
Yeah, but
boy, if you ain't a nigga, you see how a nigga don't wanna see you have goddamn.
Your birthday coming up, ain't it? Bitch. I got you, my boy.
Fuck you, man. Hey, you an asshole if you even keep that motherfucker this long. I ain't fucking with that.
I ain't scratched the pen off of the nothing. So
you don't even know how. Yeah, go and get it to him. That motherfucker might be loaded. No, it might be. They might be adding $10 a month.
I told them to check the balance.
Fuck you, man. You know what's about to be the next beat?
What?
Damn Charles Barkley and Draymond.
Draymond, yeah. Man, niggas forgot how cold Charles Barkley was for Draymond to be talking that shit to him like that.
Right.
Nigga Charles Barkley? Nigga, Draymond, you ain't even got your own shoe. Charles Barkley had his own shoes, nigga.
Man, Draymond Green don't need his own shoe.
So you think he better than Charles Barkley?
No, I know he ain't. I know he ain't. But I do think he might whoop Charles Barkley.
Who, Draymond? Man, you forgot, Lou. Charles Barkley used to kick niggas' ass, man. You remember Shaq?
The Lakers are trying to get out and break now, but the wrong people are shooting. I wouldn't want Fisher necessarily to take that shot that fast.
Uh-oh. Oh, there's a swing by O'Neal. And they got a brouhaha on the floor.
Why it's so sad.
Yeah.
Because he the nigga who used to whoop niggas ass.
Oh, you know he pulling them pistols.
Them young niggas energetic.
Cause he a hothead. That nigga Chuck coming like, man, boy, you don't bag the fuck up. You thought I was with that fight shit? I could tell that how Charles would tell the nigga.
See, that's what you from leaving out. Charles like to drink too goddamn much. Draymond catch drunk Charles slipping, he gonna put them hands on his ass.
So that ain't no sneak?
That ain't no sneak. Because Charles knew he was drunk. Yeah, okay. He got to talk. He's real smart. Draymond been working out, drinking water, eating fruit. And that nigga black as hell, too.
Hey, that nigga Charles Barkley said, that nigga Draymond ain't tough without the mother boys. Because you know Steph hurt and Clay hurt. Nigga been filing that on purpose.
I would hate for Charles Barkley to yoke that young nigga up and choke him out, though. Yeah. I remember Charles Barkley was very angry. He threw a nigga through a window.
Man, you don't remember when that nigga scoop slammed Shaq?
Yeah. That's why Shaq be beefing with him so much.
Yeah, he still remember that shit.
Yeah.
I know Shaq wanna just go goddamn uppercut the nigga, you know, just for the hell of it.
Right.
Man, I got to arguing with a nigga in Walmart a month ago. Shouldn't have even been arguing.
Hold up, bro. How the fuck you just end up in a...
Because when you said the scoop slam shit, it just made me think about...
You just in Walmart arguing with mother.
Man, I'm on aisle 3. So I'm walking past, nigga like, hey, I seen you on the 85 South Shore. I was like, well, that what's up? I dap him up. He was like, bro, Lous don't be freestyling. Out of nowhere, the nigga tell me you don't be freestyle. I got mad. I was like, bro, I be that. I be seeing him come up with the shit on top of his head. Nigga said, you be writing that shit. So I said, if the nigga watch the episode, he gonna see you ain't said shit about rapping. If a nigga play a beat, I said, Lous gonna do what the fuck he do.
Hey, man, I'm so sick of goddamn trying to convince niggas that it's other ways. What more can I do?
I don't know, man.
What more can I do?
You talk about coronavirus. We need a coronavirus song, Lous.
No, man. Nah.
Why the fuck you trick me? Hey, it's all right to trick niggas watching.
Nah. Because when you said that, it just reminded me that no matter what I do, niggas still going to have the same impression. Oh, he wrote that too. It's never gonna be enough.
I don't know, Lowe's.
That's why you're gonna have to tell me specifically who this so-called nigga is.
I ain't even get his name. I ain't even get what I had in the buggy. I got mad and walked the fuck out. I said, nigga, you don't know Lowe's, nigga. The fuck is wrong with you, nigga?
Man, I appreciate that, bro. Appreciate it.
Nigga talking about some old bro. You just brainwashed. You think that man I said, nigga, what? I said, bro, let me get the fuck out this Walmart, nigga, before some shit go down.
And you know Walmart has been known to be like that spot.
Nigga, man.
I'm glad you ain't do a nigga like the baby. You saw the baby slap shit out that girl?
Oh, man.
Let's say allegedly, because we don't know if he really.
But you heard the apology, though?
I don't know if that was him.
But he issued an apology if it was or not him.
Right. If you know, whether it was or it wasn't.
The nigga said, man or female, he reacted.
Man. I don't
That know. Nigga need a PR team with him at all times.
But he don't, though. Because, motherfucker, hey, man, I feel like if you replace whoever that was, you know, maybe it was the baby or whatever. If you replace him with anybody in that situation, if a bitch get in your face, you're going to react. That's just how you react sometimes.
The footage went clear.
I think, would it be the same reaction if it was a woman rapper who did that?
I could see Young M.A. doing that.
I feel like I could see her slapping a nigga, though. Like, if Young M.A. got off stage and slapped a nigga, would anybody give a fuck?
But how could the nigga react?
Hmm?
The nigga could react how he want to react.
I'm saying, what he a bitch nigga, though. She got him good, too. And she got him good. Like, she hit him like a nigga.
So what he do? Do he do a lawsuit? Hold his face? What he do?
If a nigga have a lawsuit against Young M.A. for some shit like that, he a pussy off top. Damn. Off top.
But what if he just trying to run the checkup?
That's still some whole ass shit. Like that nigga who stole all that money from the stripper bowl.
You thought that was whole shit?
Yeah. I don't know, though. I can't say that. It's 50-50 when it comes to that.
Yeah.
Because that nigga did what came natural. Y'all just going to throw all this goddamn money on the floor.
Hey, but when he kept pulling that shit out, I was like, hey, man, Holmes a real one. But I don't like...
We should invite him on the show.
He got to tell his side of the story.
Right.
This the platform for him.
Right. Well, he did tell his side of the story. To whom? He said he needed it. He went on Instagram to Cardi B.
Lous, this the thing. He didn't have the right person interviewing. That's like when Gayle... You got to have the right person to interview you so you can have the right... If you interview him, it'll come out a different...
First of all...
And he'll have a fan base.
People got to stop going to Gayle for interviews.
Because that's who Gayle tried to interview him. He turned it down.
Shut the fuck up.
Okay. Lous, I don't get paid a lot of you.
First of all, he wouldn't have went to Gayle first. If the shit was official, he would have went on Vlad TV first.
Yeah.
Vlad got the streets unlocked. So he would have did that first. And then the Breakfast Club. Something like that.
That nigga doing features now, though.
They ain't $40. I ain't fucking with him. Really, these niggas charging way too much for features. I'm just gonna really
$40 too much?
No, I'm just saying. I'm just saying, like, you know, niggas got $40 features out here going off.
Imagine a nigga do a feature and you never put the song up.
You gonna ask about that feature?
You gonna ask about it?
You gotta drop it.
Do you get the money back? So Lous, the nigga that you done made a deposit for. Y'all do the song, do the video. You like, I can get somebody else on this. Do you ask for your money back?
Mm-mm. You just add all of them. You done paid for the verse already.
Okay.
You dropped 2-3 burden. It's the street mix, mixtape version, and the album version. Because, you know, rappers love to say who ain't on the album these days. Okay. Who you got on the album? Well, it's mostly just me. You know, I got a few features on there, and I really just wanted to show everybody what I could do. Who you got on there? Got two of my artists on there. We really kept this one in-house.
Then you get the album. This nigga got Young Thug on the motherfucker, Future on the motherfucker, Cardi B.
He the worst part of the album.
Yeah.
You a ever heard one of your favorite artists on a feature from somebody you ain't know, you be like, who the fuck is this nigga? Yeah. But then you automatically got to respect them because, like, well, they came up with that bag.
Yeah.
I want to hear some of them goddamn features Boosie been doing on Instagram.
Every time Boosie hit a city, he lock in. But I wonder, do they put it out? Well, I know they put it out, but do you think Boosie bullshit him?
Nah, that nigga do a whole verse, and he don't be bullshitting because he like to keep shit moving. Mm-hmm. That nigga be having Instagram so goddamn lit.
Nigga, he lied. Do you see him sit down with Jada?
They won't have Boosie on there. They don't know what Boosie gonna come on there. Yeah. Boosie, how you feeling today? I won't fuck, man. I won't fuck, Miss Jada. No disrespect. You tell Will I look. I been wanting to fuck. Yo, sex ass. Yo, pretty ass. Woo. Boosie, calm down. My children are here. My kids here too. All my kids here.
For the love of Boosie.
And they know too. Tell them. My dad want to fuck. That's right, goddammit.
So.
And I got $1,000. Pull your puss out.
How you doing, hey?
Pull your puss out, Jada. Goddamn it, Rihanna already got somebody. I'm like, man, Boosie, you got to calm down.
Bro. That nigga said, ASAP Rocky, that my little partner, so I'm gonna let them have that. He still want it though. Hey, so do he go on the Jada and Willow, and do he apologize for the Dwayne Wade comment?
No.
But it's not him.
He can't, because his mama already done called him.
Oh, okay.
His mama done called him already. When your mama step in and tell you wrong, you wrong.
But he done come in it on now.
Hey, man. I try to stay away from certain shit.
No, he done went and come in it on a new picture and put shaking my head.
Yeah, he did.
You saw that?
That's how he feel. Yeah. Ain't nothing wrong with having feelings. But everybody can have feelings.
But his mama told him don't speak on it.
Hey, leave them folks alone. Quit touching shit. You see how it circle back?
Yeah.
That's exactly what I mean, bro. It ain't about you all the time. Let them folks live their life. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You can't win out here in these streets. Mm. Shit.
That's tough, man.
And you never know. You never know. God bless him. God bless him. That's how I feel. What else happened? Oh, there's a lot of shit going on. You saw they did Spike Lee.
Oh, New York Knicks.
They did ass wrong.
They did that. Nigga.
They dead ass wrong. Spike Lee is the most loyal fan they got. You know how many games?
For no reason. You know how many he could have been switched and went to a team that's winning.
You know how many games he done watched them motherfuckers lose?
Nigga, and up close.
Right there. He said he spent over $10 million on them tickets out of all these years.
Man, by this time, I'm thinking this nigga done started getting the shit free. I didn't know he was still paying to see them niggas bullshit like that. Come on, Spike.
You know what $10 million could have did in another community?
This nigga could have made Malcolm X 2.
Do the right thing, 3, 4, and yeah. 5. Yeah. He could have made 6 more movies or something.
You know one of my favorite movies by that nigga? And it gets slept on? More Better Blues.
That's a good-ass movie.
Yeah, nigga slept on that shit, man.
That's a good. But Spike Lee made a lot of good-ass movies. Yeah, but that was just something to make movies on. For everybody.
Which one?
Like when he started making like shit like Red Hook Summer and shit. Exactly. Them shits with the white people in it.
Yeah, he need to check that
out. He should have goddamn stayed over there making them good HBCU movies.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
She hate me.
Yeah. Girl 6.
Yeah.
You know. He got a lot of classics over there.
They got plenty of classics.
Plenty of good goddamn classics, man. She hate me. Damn, they got all them women pregnant.
They fucked Spike Lee up bad, man. That shit wasn't cool at all.
Nah. Man, it's so hard to find loyalty like that. You know, Knicks ain't been shit since 76.
And they ain't gonna be shit.
But he was still wanting to go see them lose.
Yeah.
And argue with the other players. They down by 30 points. He arguing with a nigga. That's gall. That's audacity.
It's now the players, they laugh. Like, they don't even argue back with the nigga. They just chill out, Spike.
Hey, man. You taking this fan shit too.
Yeah, man. Watch out, boy. I ain't in with that shit.
Right. I feel bad for Spike Lee. That shit is embarrassing. Yeah. It's really embarrassing, you know, for that man to spend all that money on that sorry ass team.
Next year, the nigga courtside at the Brooklyn Nets game. That's how you answer back.
He ain't gonna do it.
He got too much pride.
Too much pride. And for what? That's why I'm a fan of sports, but not like that. I'm not loyal to none of these motherfucking teams. I don't give a fuck.
Nigga, the teams have changed. I know one nigga got the New Jersey Nets tatted on his back, and now they the Brooklyn Nets. Now what do you do?
That ain't it. That's a whole nother team.
That's a whole nother team. Your team expired.
Right. People be loyal as fuck to these. I do not get it. But they always have a little story behind them. Like, yeah, my granddaddy used to always. The fuck they got to do with anything? You give more fuck about the team than the team.
See, in basketball, I ain't really got no team. Whatever LeBron go. That nigga just exciting to watch, man. Who your favorite player, Lous?
Yeah, hell, it can't be nobody but LeBron. You know what? In my heart, I feel like that nigga my cousin. I've been watching him so long. I remember watching
nigga,
LeBron.
We watched his kids grow up.
Nigga, when his jersey was too big.
Yeah.
You remember that shit?
Nigga, you remember his draft day suit?
Come on, man. When they used to have to cover up the tattoos. Man, I didn't watch this nigga whole career. I didn't sing about 90% of the games.
Yeah.
You know, so that's
him
my
and
nigga.
His old lady, but not held it down.
Right.
Yeah.
You didn't watch the whole family. I'm watching little LeBron now. Mm-hmm. This nigga can hoop his ass off. I seen his first dunk. I was like, man, I'm so proud of my family. You saw Bronny? He hit a nigga with the step back from the free throw line.
Ooh, nasty.
Yeah, the little son. Then it's Taco Tuesday every Tuesday.
Nigga, and they not having just regular family members over. Mm-hmm. They having some of the team come over. Like, this nigga LeBron a sponsor now.
Exactly.
He got Anthony Davis eating tacos with you.
And then it don't just be the popular niggas. He be letting everybody come through.
Yeah.
Rondo stopped through and got a taco.
Nigga, he was recording somebody. I was like, who the fuck is that? Exactly. But the nigga said Taco Tuesday. Like,
man, that nigga be listening to all the trap rap and everything. You know what I love about LeBron?
That nigga fuck with Dolph.
The nigga ain't never flexed on us. We know this nigga got all the money in the world. What he drive?
A Kia.
You ever seen him driving?
That nigga in the back.
Come on, man. What does yard look like?
Damn.
This nigga is really wealthy.
The most we done seen is this nigga kitchen, bro.
Is it? And it was just from the table up. You don't know what the floor look like in that bitch. The floor might be made by Nike. You never know.
You just said some real shit.
This nigga whole. You forgot LeBron signed a $1 billion contract with these motherfuckers, didn't he? Wasn't it? How much was it? Shit was $1 billion.
Still hanging with the same niggas.
Nigga got four friends. Same barbershop.
Damn.
You know what's crazy? People done forgot. Watch this. I'm about to fuck your mind up. We ain't seen LeBron James' mama since he told her ass to sit the fuck down.
Sit the fuck down. They were playing the Celtics. It was on a Sunday.
That nigga was still in Cleveland then, wasn't he?
Mm-hmm.
He said,
sit the fuck down. He did it just like that.
We ain't seen her since. That been about 2-3 years. I hope she's okay.
And you know what I like about this whole situation? Gayle didn't try to take her sneak ass and interview LeBron mama and try to tear the shit apart.
Ooh.
Cause they'll do some shit like that, Lous. Ooh. Well, how did it make you feel, Gloria? Shut the fuck up.
Wow. You said some shit that time.
Oh man. I'm noticing the bigger picture.
You said some shit that time, bro.
You wanna ask all them dumb questions. You knew not to fuck with LeBron.
But I'm just saying, if they don't see by now, if you go sit down with Gayle, you asking for problems.
Yeah.
Just stay the fuck away from her.
She killed R. Kelly.
R. Kelly killed it. Look, at this point, don't tell me shit else R. Kelly done did, okay? I'm sick of him and his bitches. He need to be, lock all the motherfuckers up. Lock all the motherfuckers up, man. I'm sick of everybody. Because at this point, motherfuckers know better.
God, I don't know what to say, bro.
R. Kelly in jail for goddamn life. He ain't never getting out. Ever. He'll never be the same.
Bro, I just feel like out of all the people that went to jail, like this nigga Bill Cosby ain't giving us nothing. Like, the nigga, like, it like he gave up.
No, he didn't.
Nigga ain't dropped no comedy special. The nigga ain't, he just in that chilling.
The fuck you mean he ain't dropped no comedy special? This nigga's like in prison, man.
Los, niggas drop music all the time. So you mean to tell me, Los, with all that talent and all the shit he done gave to the game, he just going to his cell and unclocked out? Like, come on, that ain't what you been teaching us all these years. 80, there's no limit on creativity. See, with thoughts and rebuttals like that, that's what make him not want to give back. It's so many niggas, if he drop a Netflix special, gonna tune in. Cause we want to know what he thinking.
Nigga, are you crazy? All
right, Lou. So tell the truth. Hypothetically speaking, he dropped a Netflix special. Woo. You not gonna click play.
Woo. No.
Bill Cosby, shut the fuck up,
Bill
man.
Bill Cosby ain't never been funny to me.
But I'm saying you still gonna be like, man, what he talking about? You no. Never watched the Cosby Show, Lous?
Yes.
Okay.
I did. That was before I was old enough to know what really goes on. I ain't fucked with Bill Cosby since the pound cake speech.
So you ain't never watched Different World?
He wasn't on that.
But he was the producer. I'm saying, like, he got so...
Nigga, do you know what the producer do? Nothing. That's the nigga who makes shit possible.
They so be... what if he produced a show from where he at?
Now.
His cellmate got a magnificent story, but it need to reach the masses.
Bill Cosby can't call nobody to produce nothing no more. Do you not get it? It's over with. It's a wrap. His name is fucked up. Ain't nobody gonna give him no more chances. Not unless he get out and start his own shit with his own money. That is the only, and that shit gonna be so independent and bootleg. Bill Cosby won't even believe how unfamous he is right now. Do you see how goddamn?
I can't believe you saying this.
Nigga, are you crazy? Did you see what O.J. Simpson posted the other day? The nigga talking about who's afraid of the coronavirus. This nigga that bought some styrofoam cups, some water, and some tissue.
Them two different people, man.
Okay, I'm just saying. Once your ass is over with, it is over with. Now, you can get mad at me all you want to.
I ain't mad. I'm just a
you
little upset.
You really just sat here and asked, why the fuck Bill Cosby ain't dropping no comedy special? It is nothing to laugh about at this point. Do you know what the fuck he did?
But, Lous, that's what we want to hear his side of the story. Kevin Hart done dropped Laugh at My Pain.
Kevin Hart ain't been to prison, nigga. It's different.
All right. So you get a charge or two and you just give up.
A two.
Or 11. Or 26.
So you think all them ugly white women.
No, I don't believe that. In okay, my heart, that's all. Okay. Fuck it. That's why you just didn't say that.
Okay, I was making
no, I don't believe Bill Cosby did that to all them fucking white ladies. All
right.
Who the fuck? How? How? This nigga got, if he did all that, don't you understand that Bill Cosby is one of the most prolific motherfucking R words in our generation in history? That is nigga, how? Exactly. Shit just get quiet. You can't even fathom how. One thing that you ain't never got to steal if you a rich black man and you a famous entertainer is some white lady pussy. We all know that.
And Lous, during them time, it went, you know how many rich black niggas it is now? Nigga, he was one of one.
He was the only one.
He was one of one.
For about 30 years.
Bitch, you know who room you in? What you think, we came here to watch Cosby Show?
Mr. Cosby will fuck you now.
Yeah. It's a line. Not right now. Like, he turning the shit down.
Hey, man, I don't know if you do your research or not, but there's a lot of strange-ass Bill Cosby stories on the internet.
Lous, that's what I'm trying to say. So if this special come about, he's disgusted.
I don't want to be the bearer of bad news, but there will be no more Bill Cosby comedy special. So. And I don't even want you to build that up in your head. Bow that under things that'll never happen again.
So, Ken, what about an unsung episode?
Now, TV1 might fuck with that all day.
Yeah, okay.
That's a 3-part series at least.
Will you watch it?
Yeah, I'm a, not only will I watch it, I record that.
So, Lous, you mean to tell me you'll watch this, but you won't watch it if he drop a comedy special?
Actually, I don't even want him to be in the TV One special. He don't get to say no parts, just old clips. But so we'll never hear inside the story. I'm glad they haven't sent Gayle up there to interview him yet.
Oh, she tried. She tried.
What happened?
Camille stopped it.
And she called her fucking dog head bitch. And then nobody said nothing.
Yeah, shit, nobody said nothing to Camille because she texted as well. You slick dog head bitch. You wanna come attack my husband at his lowest point. Bitch, we don't need your money.
Who you think taking care of her while he locked up?
Judge Joe Brown.
Laid up. Big chill.
Sneaky motherfucker.
Some one of them old niggas over there. Oh, Ron Asley probably laid up over there. Mr. Big.
Hey, and you know Mr. Big, he probably a little nasty nigga. Cosby Show, come on, man, cut that shit off.
Disrespecting
him.
Wearing his robe.
Yeah.
With BC on the chair.
He said stand with Big Cop.
Been writing music like a motherfucker in the real house.
Yeah, man.
Well, you know somebody been over there to see him?
You know it, like, at that age, it's a little minor shit.
He just be coming over there to sit with her on the porch.
Camille, I trimmed them hedges for you.
Thanks, Harold.
Yeah. Come get you. I made a little pound cake. Come taste a piece of this. Next thing you know,
they riding to Walmart and everything. Going to church.
Oh, yeah.
That's how you court older ladies.
He a deacon. She a first lady.
They matching. Ain't nobody even noticed.
Bill calling, why you ain't answer the phone?
Oh, man.
That when she gets sassy. Nigga, what I'm supposed to do? You I gotta live
jail.
A life.
You in jail. I ain't in jail.
Yeah, I got a life.
And hang up.
Yeah. Nigga, you wouldn't worry about where I was at when they said you allegedly did all that fuck shit. And she hang up the phone.
It's early in the week. It's Tuesday.
Get what Harold do. What wrong? Who was that?
Calm down. Don't let that bother you. Don't eat your shrimp.
They eat shrimp.
At the house. At the house. He can't say nothing.
Damn.
Big company. Harold got that truck parked outside.
What kind of truck he got?
You know he got a F-150. It's a new one, though. But he drive Ford trucks. Mm-hmm. King Ranch Edition. That's fucking crazy.
He wears shades when he drive.
Yep. He ain't had that truck when he first started coming over.
Oh, hell no.
They trying to say she bought it for him.
Yeah, but see, I could see him pulling up in a Buick at first.
Something easy, something light.
And she was like, such and such. He was like, man, I would, but I can't put all that in my trunk of my car.
Well, yeah, I got to get all this equipment over there, too, and cut this yard. You need a truck. Yeah, my truck broke down on me. That's how he got in the whip.
And then with my credit and all that,
I got the money. It's just my credit.
Yeah, I done sent my grandbabies through college, and you know I just don't want to mess up my credit. Well, Harold, you ain't got to worry about
truck no. Yep, that's how it happened to you, man. Hey, man, stop getting so deep. This has been the coronavirus episode. Hopefully, this will keep you quarantined.
Hey, Lous, quick question.
What?
So they can't pull this and put our shit on the unsung. Because I don't want them using our shit and be like, we helping the episode, talking about
that's
shit.
That's why I was wondering where you was going with that, with the comedy special. Because now people are going to be like, oh, I can't believe y'all support this motherfucker. And I don't want nobody to get it fucked up. We did not in no way condone any type of violence, man. Whether it be sexual or any of that. We do not
pardon me.
Activities.
I just like entertainment. Pardon me.
Right.
Pardon
you
me.
You might want to clarify that. Yeah. Now, they ain't never hear this part.
Yeah. Oh,
but we
please.
We do need this for a reference, so when they get to talking
and I can
that
tell
shit.
How Joe edit shit,
right?
He just gonna get you disclaiming your part.
Then he just gonna have you sitting there looking stupid.
And I'm just standing there. You know how y'all did on the other commercial, y'all always get me on some shit.
The mental health.
Yeah,
so he's sitting there looking goddamn thawed as hell.
So look, let me say this. So now with me opening up for y'all.
Right.
Somebody, a part of the staff, said it looked like a Make-A-Wish Foundation that y'all are running.
We are.
So I started from the mental health commercial. Now I'm opening. So it's like basically y'all grooming me.
What?
I don't fucking know. I'm telling you what a nigga part of your staff told me.
Well, look, I'm about to tell you one thing. You got to stop letting these niggas get to you, bro.
It didn't get to me, but when the nigga said the shit, he laughed and walked off. So I asked other niggas part of the team, asking Chad, Cat, and Joe. I'm like, hey, like, man, what the fuck this white boy talking about? You know what I'm saying? I asked them just like that. They were like, man, Ryan just bullshitting with you. I'm like, no, he don't need to play with me like
man,
that.
Don't call Ryan white, man. That shit will make him mad.
Man, well, fuck it. He made me mad.
I'm trying to tell you, man, that shit. Nigga fight real good. He
man, I don't give a fuck, man. You ain't gonna just disrespect me blatantly like that, right, Lo.
Man, you
calling me a Make-A-Wish nigga?
Man, keep talking loud, man. Ain't gonna get to kicking you in them shins with them hard-ass legs, man. That dude Asian. He eats snake hearts.
Man, and I'm bringing it on. I'm thinking you finna check the shit. You telling me don't fuck with him?
I'm telling you that motherfucker bad news, bro. I wouldn't let you walk over there to no ass whooping.
I ain't say I was gonna approach the nigga,
that
but
that nigga run marathons, bro.
Nigga ain't gonna call me no Make-A-Wish nigga, man.
He just saw you living your dreams.
I'm saying, but
you just ungrateful. That's what that is.
So now I'm
every time a nigga say something to you, you take it the wrong way. You know, got to arguing with this nigga in Walmart about some shit you know ain't true.
Nah, but look, it's just like, I don't know. It's just certain things when it come about how niggas when I address you about, I'm like, bro. Why Joe put the commercial? Damn, a nigga put you in a star, make you a star of a commercial. You get mad at me.
You ain't never even been exposed to that many people before. And you want to holler about some shit.
But I'm just saying, Los, I don't want to be an advocate for mental health.
Well, you would rather be an advocate for a Bill Cosby comedy special. You the only nigga that's calling for that?
I didn't call for it. I just don't know what he's doing.
He's not doing nothing.
So I would want documentary.
He's serving time.
So you mean to tell me, Los, he just doing his time?
Yes. That's all he's doing. Time. It's over with.
So, Los, I'm the only one and I hear niggas whispering, what about a redemption?
Nobody.
He need a redemption tour.
Ain't nobody listening to what niggas is talking about.
Okay. All right.
We see, that's one another thing we have to learn. We got to let these people go. Sometimes the motherfuckers is bad seeds. We have a good run with them, and then we at that point of our life where we get to see the ups and the downs.
This the final question, Los. You're not no percent curious of his day-to-day life behind the walls.
I know what he does in prison. That nigga get up in the morning and work in the kitchen or the library for 50 cents a week.
So he like the nigga on Shawshank Redemption.
He get 1 hour of rec time a day.
What he do during rec time?
He doing push-ups like everybody else.
So he doing his push-ups.
Yeah. Bill Cosby got shanks and everything. All type of protection.
So, Los, you don't think the people will want to see this?
No. 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 Because once you see that, it's going to make you look at Bill Cosby different. Like, I ain't know that nigga was deep in the blood. All like
right, which camera it is, man? I do not want to see nothing from Bill Cosby.
Man, Bill Cosby going to shock the world if you got to see that shit. Nigga, street nigga going to be like, bro, Bill Cosby the realest. Man, he fuck with the B's and the C's. Yeah. Man, that nigga he tied into the Mexican mafia.
See, niggas don't know
don't
how that
nothing
prison
move
shit
unless
works.
He say move. Man,
I can see this nigga walking
give
down.
Give me about two more years.
It's
gonna be right there
him
on YouTube. Nigga gonna be like, man, niggas gonna think I'm lying. Right hand to God, nigga. Bill Cosby had everybody in that bitch read.
Guess who interviewing him?
Dr. Seuss books. That nigga taught at least 200 niggas how to read.
Guess who interviewing his cellmate? Gayle. So how did Bill make you feel?
Man, he made me believe in myself. He taught me how to read. I picked myself up by my bootstrap, man. I got my life together, man. His cell was right next door to mine, so I spent a lot of time with him. He used to always put me up on game and shit like that, you know.
You know Bill and not telling them stories. Them niggas like, boy, you lying.
You lying. Man. No, it's quite true.
Pulled up on Cracker with hey.
Man. They got him.
First nigga with the Ferrari.
First one, baby.
I pulled up to the lot.
It was me, Sammy Davis Jr., Dean Martin. And they named me like, who that was, Uncle Bill? I remember Bob Barker used to bring all the cocaine. Bill and that getting loose, my nigga. You know that nigga. You know he done got drunk one of them Friday nights with them young boys, man. You know he have.
It just started popping
man,
shit.
Man, just talking big shit.
Hey, never mind.
See? You this is too touching to you, man.
Yeah, because like.
You too deeply invested.
Yeah, like I just don't know, man.
Well, I mean, at least you got a heart, my nigga, and you care.
But when he called home, I wonder, like, what he say. Like, you know when they say the name.
You know, dude that slipped up and answered the phone before.
Who, Harold?
Hell yeah.
Oh, no. Longe, tell me that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no.
Who is that? Oh, that's just my friend. What?
Ooh, that nigga Bill probably beat a nigga to sleep when he got off that phone.
No, he didn't.
What's wrong, OG? You know they call him OG, Los. He a OG in the OG, everything good? That nigga just walk crawl.
But they old man punching. He ain't did nothing to that young boy.
The young nigga don't even want to fight.
Bro. OG tripping.
Man, OG need to take his medicine.
Send that young man that I hit some soups.
You think niggas put money on Bill Books? Nobody.
That motherfucker got way too. He penitentiary rich already.
Oh, okay.
He rich in
so the he got like a black card in that motherfucker.
Shot caller.
That nigga probably got so many soups and noodles lined
man,
up on
his cell. His cell is where it's at. And ain't nobody never stole nothing. Mm-hmm. And the crazy part, he got all the snacks, don't never eat them.
Oh, niggas coming to hang, Los.
You got to read to get something out of here. You got to read.
So a nigga used that, hey, OG, what book you told me to check out? He tell him something, he's like, hey, you mind if I get you one of them cup noodles?
Get you one when you finish.
Oh, so it's like a program.
You got to talk to him about the book.
So you got to have a book report.
What?
Dang.
You know them young niggas be running down to us. Hey, we cooking upstairs, OG. You want some of this? We brought you a piece anyway. What is this? It's beef jerky with some cheese melted on it. It's good, motherfucker. You know it, man. But it's over with. That's over. Then you can just write that off. Ain't no more. Anything you want to say in closing, man? Because this might be your last time you get to talk to these folks with this virus and shit going around. They're going to turn up the heat next week.
Yeah, with this and my Bill Cosby comments.
Yeah, you pretty. They probably going to cancel you.
Shit.
So, you know, if we have to go another direction, at least you'll understand. At least you understand. I mean, you did it to yourself.
Damn, right in my face like that.
Hey, man, what you think I'm supposed to do? You know
nigga,
I mean?
You egg me on.
I told you not to ask for no Bill Cosby comedy special.
But I'm saying, Los, you asked me why would I want it. I got to answer your question.
Hey, man.
Hey, fuck that. This is my first strike.
You going to apologize?
Yeah. No, I'm just saying, nigga, we supposed to have a mean or forum about this shit. You don't get fired me.
When the cancel culture decided to cancel you, it ain't nothing you could do.
Los, you done said way worse shit.
That's not how you gauge this.
Oh.
It might feel
so
right.
So it kind of like I'm dry snitching now that I'm right. Saying you. Yeah.
Yeah, you just try to throw me under the bus. Yeah. I see what type of nigga you are. Los, you just did work. Hey, whoa, they didn't catch me. They caught your ass, nigga.
I'm on the fire. Man, what the fuck all that shit Los done did?
I put my time in. I've been canceled multiple times. I get
and you
canceled
keep bouncing
two,
back.
Three times a week.
They can't fire you, Los.
I thought they was gonna get me out of there when that day I asked, "Do studs get wet?"
But now, nah, cause then you had studs actually start.
Them comments got lost in the hate.
Yeah, they.
You know who really be doing that shit the most? People like when they get mad about the gay shit. It be people who ain't even gay in there arguing. What is you arguing about?
Then they call you homophobic.
I don't understand what homophobic means really. If like, cause the I don't think that's the right word. Phobia means a fear of. That means every time you saw some gay people, you'd be like, ah! Woo! Oh, shit! They, man! Somebody should have let me know!
What the fuck y'all doing here?
Hey, man. What's that shit where you scared of clowns? Now, that shit real, where you be like, it's a clown! Hey, man, get the clown! And you start like hyperventilating and shit. Don't nobody do that when they say gay, when they see some gay people?
Nah, I ain't never seen that.
Right. I don't think that's the right word for me.
That's a good observation.
That's not how you can really classify it. I don't have no quarrels with them people. You know, that's their shit. Let them have it.
Man, y'all stay safe from the coronavirus.
Ain't no way to really do that.
Yeah, well.
I don't like when people say stuff. They be like, you gonna catch a flight. Hey, man, have a safe flight. I'm not driving this motherfucker. You tell that to the pilot.
Hey, Lo, you tweeted some shit, man. When you said... The Uber driver asked,
"Was I going in the airport?
What you going in the airport?"
That shit was dead ass serious, man. This nigga, we get right to the turn, you know, the little shit to go to the airport. This nigga said, "Hey, bro, you going in the airport?" I was like, "Nigga, are you serious right now?"
Like, no, you just ride checking
just
the
trap. Just ride me by that motherfucker. I just want to see who outside loading baggage this morning. Goof ass nigga. Then Uber gonna hit me talking about, we really like to help you with this matter. I was like, man, get the fuck out of here.
You reported the nigga?
No.
Oh.
No snitch. Oh. That nigga wasn't doing shit. He was just dumb. Huh?
They tweeted
you?
Yeah.
Oh.
We really like to help you with this matter. Ain't no matter to help me with. Goof ass.
Yeah.
That nigga really asked me if I was going in the airport, though. Sometimes shit just be too amazing to make up. We gotta get the fuck out of here though, man, cause you know it's getting
a new day.
It's a whole new day. It's getting late,
man.
And the virus is out here.
Not this late.
It is. It's out here. Keep washing those hands, your ass. Keep some hand sanitizer around. Lysol. Stop coughing in people's faces. Shit like that. Don't be out here butt naked without no blankets. It's still wintertime. It's flu season. Anything else now? Fill your tank up, because we don't know when them gas prices gonna jump back up.
Oh, when them gas prices get back up, I might start just selling gas.
Oh, I feel like, hey, man, you know it is that time of year. Niggas gonna have them flat screens in about 2 weeks. So make sure you put you some tax money up so you can get two of them this year. Mm-hmm. Flat screens will be out soon, because I feel like the weather breaking up just slightly. So as soon as we get them first three warm days in a row, them flat screens gonna be out here.
But Los, this what niggas on the street gotta understand. The prices done cut so low in the store. Nigga, you can't go $30 under what the store's selling.
I could just go to
the store. Yeah, Best Buy giving you the motherfucker $300.
That's what I'm saying. So right now I feel like 50 inches on the street should be about $75.
Right.
What about if it's with the Fire TV, like the Fire Stick, all that included?
That Fire Stick street value ain't but $10, $15 at this point.
Damn.
And that's just to replace it. Everybody done had one already. You done already spent a good $30, $40. You know what I'm saying? So you really, if you done bought two already, because you had to have one for upstairs and downstairs. So shit, if the preloaded Fire Stick ain't already about $15, niggas is scalping prices. The street economy is way down, cause it ain't really nothing that everybody want right now. Even iPhone on the street ain't really, people don't even really steal phones like that no more.
Yeah, niggas done start turning them shit into lost and found.
Hey, bro, hey, you left your phone. I don't even get down like that no more, bro. Man, let me get the fuck out of here. This has been another 85 South Show production.
Yeah.
My name is Karlous Miller, and this has been my man, Navv Greene.
Yes.
He the only nigga I know that wants to see a Bill Cosby comedy special.
And you keep, like, he done edit this shit out, dog. Good night.
Fuck you, man.
So the shit get edited, you just put it back in there.
Yeah, we gonna throw that. We gonna keep bringing it back.
Ryan, so you don't want to see what Bill Cosby doing in jail? Yeah.